Hey, what's up everyone and welcome to Daily Code Buffer. In this video, we are going to create a simple Quarkus REST API with Kotlin. So let's jump into it. We'll be doing a very basic example here today. If you want to learn in depth, let me know in the comment section below. I'll create a tutorial for that. Now in this code.quarkus.io, we'll give a group name to com.dailycodebuffer. Okay, we'll give our artifact ID to Quarkus Kotlin demo. Okay, we'll be using build tool as May 1. Okay, all the details will be remaining same. And let's add the extensions. So we'll be adding REST-EC-JSONB and we'll be also adding Kotlin extension. Okay, now let's generate our application. Our application is downloaded. Now let's open this in IntelliJ IDEA. Okay, you can see that our application, we have Kotlin folder, we have package com.dailycodebuffer and we have one default resource file. We have application.properties file as well. Let's change our port to 8083. Okay, for our application, quarkus.http.port equals to 8083. Now let's create a simple example where we'll be adding a book and reading a book from the array list of book with the help of Kotlin language. Okay, so let's create a controller. We'll be creating a book controller, new Kotlin class book controller. Okay, let's give it a path. Book, okay, and we'll also configure the how data is consumed and produced from this controller. So we'll be adding @ produces media type dot application JSON. Okay, same way we will add in consumes. Okay. Now let's create one entity book. We'll create new Java class book and let's add some properties over here. Okay, we'll add variable ID equals to variable ID. Okay, long variable title and variable ISBN number. Okay, now when we define these variables over here in the constructor, it won't create a default constructor, it will create a parameterized constructor when we are passing these values. Okay, but when we are working with JSON and directly parsing data from request body to JSON, we need a default constructor of the entities. So what we can do over here is we can pass the default values to this variable, so that way Kotlin will create a default constructor for us. So let's give all the default values over here. Okay, now we need to make a null safe for these variables. Okay, so we'll add a question mark over here, otherwise it won't allow to add null values. You can see that we are getting compilation error over here, so we are adding null safe. So this way this will allow the default constructor and the parameterized constructor for our book entity. Now let's go to our controller and create some routes for that. First of all, we'll be creating an array list of books. In that array list, we'll be storing our books and we'll do the operations on that. So for that, we'll add private val books and this books of type array list of book. Okay. Now let's create a method, function addBooks, which will take book as input parameter and will return that book as an return parameter, and we'll add the particular book which we are getting from here into our books array. Okay, so we'll add books dot add book which we are getting. Okay, and will return the book object. Let's add the path variable over here, and this will be a post method. So we'll be adding post method type. Okay, now let's run this application and check from our postman. You need to type the command mvn compile quarkus colon dev. Okay, so let's run this. You can see that our application is building. Okay, our application is started on port 8083. Now let's open postman. Okay, inside postman, let's add post method and we'll add the objects. We'll go to our body part and let's add id equals to 1, title equals to book 1, we can add book 2, whatever, and the ISBN number. Okay, and the URL is 8083 and book which we added over here. Let's hit the send button. You can see that the data has been added and we are getting the book object. Let's add one more book. That's it, send. Okay, you can see that we are able to add the books and we are getting the output as our books. Now let's add one more method. Let's add a method to fetch all the books, and we'll also add a method to fetch the books by its title. Function get all books. Now inside this we can write what we need to pass. We need to pass this array list of books. Okay, return books, and this is get request. Okay, and the return type will be array list of books. Okay, but you can see here this is very much verbose over here. Okay, Kotlin is not known for this. The return type of our get all books is the array list of books, and we are not doing any operations over here. We are directly returning the books. So instead of defining the return type over here and returning the list of books from within the method, what we can directly do is just remove all this code and just we can assign the value as books. Okay, so this will return the list of books as an return parameter in our get all books method. Pretty neat, right? Now let's run this application again. Let's go to postman. Let's add books over here. Okay, we added the book. Let's add one more book, book 2, and the new number as 3. Okay, now let's change the post method to get method, and this will fetch all the books within the array list. You can see that we are getting all the books. Okay, let's add one more book. Need to change to post. Okay, book is added, and let's change again to get method. You can see that we'll be getting 3 books. Okay, now let's create a method to fetch the books based on the title of the book. Let's go back to our IntelliJ IDEA and let's create one more method. Let's add function get books by title. Okay, we'll be taking title as an input parameter as a string. Okay, the return type is book. Let's annotate with get method. Okay, now what we need to do is we need to fetch the particular book from this array list based on the title. So we'll be getting one extra parameter in the URL from the book. We need to add like which book we need to search. So we'll be adding a path over here. Okay, in that path we will define title. Okay, so this title will be an input parameter, and we'll define path parameters as well. Now let's find the book from this books array list. Let's add val book of book equals to books.find. Okay, here with the it object we will find the data based on the title we have. So it dot title equals to the title we have. and we will return book. Now be sure that this book.find may return null object as well. Okay, so we need to do the null safe. So let's add the null safe over here, and we need to add the null safe in our return parameter as well. Okay, so if there is a null object, it will not throw null pointer exception. So this method is ready. We have three methods created: to add the books, to get all the books, and to fetch the book based on the title we have. Let's go to Postman. Okay, let's add some books. Book 4, book 3, we'll add ABC, some new number. Let's add book 1 with new number. Okay, let's check, we should get all the books. Okay, now let's add the title of the book in the URL. Let's add book 1. Okay, we should get the third book, this one. Let's hit the send button. You can see that we got this book. Okay, let's search for another book. Let's search for this book. So you can see that we are getting the book, so the implementation is correct. So this way we can use Kotlin with our Quarkus applications. So this is a new support added by the Quarkus team for the Kotlin language. Hope you like this video. So that's it in this video. If you have any queries, please let us know in the comment section below. If you like this video, smash that like button, and we will see you in the next video.